The following story has been brought to you by StoriesToInspire.org.
A few years ago, I had this chus of Reuven Feinstein, the Staten Island Rosh Hashiva, Shlita and his Eishes Chayo, has a chon of Levracha, Rebbetz and Sheila Feinstein. So they were in our shul for a simcha in the White Shul in Farakwa years ago. And I was speaking about the simcha, I was speaking about Shalom Bayis. And the Rebbetzin came over to me after the speech at the Kiddush. And she says, "Well, I find I have a story to tell you." She says, "I want you to know I get my husband, the Rosh Hashiva, Reuven Feinstein, I get him a present twice a year. I get him a present on his birthday, and I get him a present on Father's Day. I'm just sharing a story. Take out of that whatever you want. I get him a present on Father's Day. I get him a present on his birthday." She says, "You know what I got him this year for his birthday? I got him a box. I got him a box. I wrapped it up in beautiful wrapping paper, a nice little red ribbon on top, and I brought it to Rosh Hashiva. And Rosh Hashiva saw it, and it looked like a piece of jewelry. He said, 'Rebbetzin, won't you get me a nice new pair of cufflinks?' And Rosh Hashiva stopped talking, just open it up. 'No, but it looks like a piece of jewelry. You got me to watch.' Rosh Hashiva stopped talking, just open it up. As he opens it up ever so carefully, opens up the box, and it's a beautiful pair of woman's diamond earrings." So Shiva looks at his wife, he says, "Rebbetzin, I thought it's my birthday, now yours." He says, "No, it is your birthday. I want to make you happy, but I know that the best thing I could get you to make you happy is getting myself a new pair of earrings. The more beautiful I look, the more you'll appreciate it. Asamayim, I'm getting you a birthday present." And when he lost his Rebbetzin and I went from the mountains to pay Rav Reuven a Shiva visit, so Rav David HaZatzal was there alongside his younger brother. And I walked in, about 50, 60 people, and I had a space, Baruch Hashem, right opposite Rav Reuven Feinstein, and I saw it was a very somber, pensive mood, kayadu in the Beis Avol, but befrat, it was a tragic, untimely loss of his Rebbetzin, and I sat down, and finally when he addressed me, I responded, I said, "Can I share a story with the Rosh Hashiva? Should I share this story with the Rosh Hashiva?" Rosh Hashiva said, "Rabbi Feinstein, I got an even better one for you." He says, "I got a better story for you." He says, "Rabbi Feinstein," Rabbi David, remember, Rabbi David Feinstein is sitting right alongside his brother. I'm not saying the story. I'm sharing it with you now, but he shared it with me at the Beis Avol. He said, "One year before that, my Rebbetzin didn't tell you this story. She got me a really big box. And I saw this big box, beautiful wrapping paper and a nice red ribbon. I said, 'Rebbetzin, what'd you get me for my birthday?' Rosh Hashiva stopped talking, open it up. I said, 'What'd you get me? A new kapot, a new bekashah. What'd you get me?' A Rosh Hashiva just opened it up and I tear it open. And it's a beautiful, beautiful, brand new, very expensive woman's dress. A woman's dress." And I said, "Rebbetzin, it's my birthday, a woman's dress." I said, "Rosh Hashiva, the more beautiful I look, the happier you'll be on your birthday. Ameva." I said, from that point on, it became known as Daddy's Dress. Everything was great, Rav Reuven tells the tzibur. He says, everything was great. It was Daddy's Dress until a Rosh Hashiva was visiting from Eretz Yisrael. And he came to the house a few minutes before Shabbos on an Erev Shabbos Kodesh. And the house was chaotic, frenzy. And a young grandchild is there at the bottom of the steps, just as the Rosh Hashiva comes in with his long flowing white beard. And the boy says, "Anybody know where Daddy's Dress is? Can we find Daddy's Dress?" Rosh Hashiva's thinking, "Do I have the right place? Am I at the right..." Shiva said, "I told my Enochloch, that's it. From now on, it's not Daddy's Dress anymore. And that's it. It's kedai to give up your next birthday present, your next Father's Day gift for the Neshei Chayo who are letting you sit to learn."
Enjoyed this story? Come again. Bring a friend. StoriesToInspire.org.